Welcome back. Frontline policing is set to get a boost in the form of body cameras for its offices. The cameras will be piloted from the middle of the year. But it's not just the authorities who are harnessing technology to fight crime. Affordable prices have made the technology more accessible to the man in the street as well. In this week's Spotlight, Kimberly Spikerman looks at the good, the bad, and the ugly of CCTV cameras.
Step out of your apartment and your movements could be picked up by a CCTV camera installed outside your neighbour's home. Electronic eyes track your every move. A police camera as you get into the lift, a traffic camera as you drive your car, or even a security camera as you walk into the office. For the authorities, electronic eyes have proven a greater help than hindrance. Police cameras are installed in at least 2,000 HDB blocks and multi-storey car parks island-wide as part of a community policing initiative. This means more effective crime fighting, particularly when battling unlicensed money lending, theft and outrage of modesty. Overall, footage from these cameras have helped solve 48 crime cases since 2012. And provided further leads in another 195 cases. For the National Environment Agency, surveillance cameras have effectively tackled high-rise littering. Since August 2012, it's deployed these cameras in some 1,000 instances at close to 700 locations. The cameras are usually deployed based on feedback and were effective in addressing the problem in about 80% of these cases. As of February this year, 95 offenders were caught on tape. Traffic surveillance cameras have also made it easier for the Land Transport Authority to keep an eye on the roads. There are 514 cameras on the expressways, 346 on key arterial roads, and 325 at key traffic junctions. LTA says this facilitates early detection of traffic situations like accidents and breakdowns so they can respond promptly. With electronic eyes everywhere you look, it's also harder for bad behaviour to go unnoticed.
Video footage is treated in the law of evidence as real evidence. In other words, it's just like you bring a knife to court to show this was the knife. There are some checks and balances, of course, that the video footage must be continuous. There must have been no tampering, that sort of thing.
Because of the affordability and high quality of home surveillance and in-car cameras, lawyers say that in the last 3 to 5 years, there's been a marked increase in video footage being used to augment cases in court. What this means is that there's little room for doubt or dispute once an incident has been captured on tape. Video footage has been used in cases such as traffic offences, abuse involving children and the elderly, as well as molest.
The case which I handled will be an outrage of modesty case. The act of outrage was committed when both the offender and the victim step out of the lift into this HDB corridor. And coincidentally, there was this unit directly in front of the lift that actually fitted this CCTV camera. They managed to capture the whole offending act in question.
The issue of privacy and the right to know that you're being filmed is one that's surfaced many times.
In Singapore, we don't have privacy laws. So long as you don't go into somebody's house or premises and the video footage is shot in public, then nobody can claim that that is an invasion of my privacy. The only time when one has to be very careful is if the video footage is most likely defamatory. For instance, you only shoot a portion of it, which may put that person, the subject, in a bad light. But if you look at the whole footage, then you understand that there was a continuity and there was a reason why the person behaved the way he did.
Awareness of the deterrent effect of CCTV cameras has also gained ground. This retailer at Sim Lim Square says demand for home, office and car CCTVs has surged. He now sells at least 100 sets a month, double what it used to be 2 years ago. And little wonder when you can get a sophisticated camera like this one for under $200. This in-car camera doesn't just track what's happening on the road in front of you, but even what's going on in the back seat. Infrared capabilities also mean clear images are captured, even at night. And when an accident happens, the camera automatically records the GPS coordinates of where it occurred.
Most of the person that has something want to monitoring for the what situation for the home or office at a car. The reason is the media or something, the newspaper, because you see a lot of case and this one, more of a consumer or customer already know had this item to let it more convenient to them. So they're starting to buy the camera. Before that, this was a new technology. A lot of customer or something people don't know how to prevent this case.
And if you aren't willing to pay a hefty sum for a surveillance camera, you can get these fake cameras for between $5 and $10. Now, these are just shells and can be stuck on the ceiling using double-sided tape. For those who buy such cameras, they do so because of its deterrent effect and hope that an untrained eye won't be able to tell the difference.
What's interesting is that even as more high-tech surveillance cameras become available to the man in the street, one profession that may not necessarily buy into this is private investigation. Private investigators are no strangers to the surveillance camera, a tool that's key to getting the job done. For example, in matrimonial disputes where concrete evidence is required. But one veteran says it's more important to know how to use what's at your disposal. Retired police officer Lionel D'Souza has run his agency since 1999. He has witnessed a changing demand for video footage as evidence, rather than just still photographs. His associates use only conventional cameras in their work, but he says it's more a matter of how these cameras are concealed and positioned to capture what's needed, rather than making use of the latest technology.
The most important is the human resource, the person behind the camera, the person operating the camera. If he's so fearful, he will not get a good shot. Different cases, different ways. Not all the same ways that you use your camera. There'll be different, and there'll be different camouflages also.
Smaller, smarter and more affordable gadgets will inevitably change the nature of surveillance. But how they're used and how scrupulous people will be when using them will eventually determine whether these gadgets turn out to be a bane or a benefit.